welcome to the aftermath of another Betfred Super League Grand Final. Another season in the books, but a familiar story. Wigan Warriors are the champions. They've beaten Hull KR. Frankie, what a day.
What a day. From start to finish, I'm lucky that I head into town beforehand and I can soak up the atmosphere there before getting down here and watching it build in intensity to what really delivered us a great game. I mean, everybody said it would be a tight game because of the quality of the two teams, and I think you'll agree we really got that feeling in the first 10 to 15 minutes that we were watching the top two teams, because nothing was giving, was it, in the first 15 minutes? And then, I suppose in classic Wigan style, why they're so good, they just ground them down and down and down, and eventually mistakes did come in the second half. You had moments of brilliance from French, kicking excellence, I thought, from Smith, and they were really the difference in what was a tight game.
Yeah, you've been soaking it up all day. 6 o'clock kickoff, grand final, but really, it starts much earlier than that.
How are you feeling about it? Excited?
Oh, yeah, it's going to be great.
Yeah, or do you think it's going to win then?
Wigan, obviously.
Obvious?
Yeah.
Are you confident?
Yeah.
We've been speaking to people and everyone's had it quite closely matched.
Up the cast.
Up the cast. are we all cast fans? No.
No. London.
We're all Yorkshire. We're supporting OKR today.
Yorkshire.
Yorkshire. Yorkshire. Yorkshire. Yorkshire.
We'll put Robins.
Are you? Yeah.
Yorkshire team in it, sir.
Yeah. We've had a few of that. Just fans of other clubs, but pick the Yorkshire team.
Absolutely. Yeah. Why wouldn't you? We're Yorkshire born, Yorkshire bred, so we're all for Yorkshire teams.
I think we're going to pinch it by about 10.
Dude, about 10, that's not pinching it.
No, I think they will. I think they'll do him quite comfortably. But hopefully it's a good game.
Yeah, I'm sure it will be. How are you getting on? We saw you last year.
Yeah, excellent.
We're back again. I might get a spot on a pint here next year.
Yeah, really looking forward to it like everyone else.
Yeah.
It should be an excellent game. Like Reg was saying there, hopefully it's like a couple of weeks ago where Wigan just won it, but it was a really good game. Got lucky with the two sin bins in that game, so Hull KR probably should have won that, but yeah, the two sin bins won it for Wigan that week, so hopefully no sin bins or red cards at this game though.
Yeah, plenty of people started early. Of course, the preparations for these two teams started in November in pre-season. The two best teams all season, Frankie.
Yeah, definitely, and we got that feeling today. There's just so much quality in them, so much professionalism in both of them. The error count is so low. There are players that can pull off bits of brilliance, but I think what you got was two really professional outfits head to head, and unfortunately there can only be one winner, because all of these players work so hard all season, and it's such a tough season in rugby league that to not get a result at the end of it is heartbreaking. But Wigan were top quality, and that's why they got four trophies to their name.
Exactly why Wigan have got four trophies to their name. But let's just run it back. Two teams that came into this game in fantastic form, fantastic battles all season, and two sets of coaches ready to see their teams go to war.
Yeah, it's been an exciting week. You know, I think we've had to rein the boys back a little bit early doors. But yeah, the back end, it's been nice and calm. Had a great captain's run yesterday, nice trip over. Spent some time together in a hotel, and yeah, the boys are nice and relaxed, and they know what to do. It's you know, I've been doing it all year. Just got to go out and perform now on the main stage.
Loads of narrative, of course. First time Hull KR have been here. History to be made. Have you used that as kind of fuel to the fire this week, or tried to keep all of that noise away?
Yeah, I think you've got to control the emotion. You've got to tap into the emotional side, but not too much. You know, the boys are excited about it. The boys deserve to be here. They know that. It's main stage, and you've got the top two playing each other. The results have shown all year that we deserve to be here. And whether it's the first time, we've got boys in there experienced who played in finals before, so they'll hopefully bring a little bit for the less experienced boys today. But it's just about performing on the night, you know, everybody hitting their 9 out of 10 performances and getting the job done.
Proper grand final weather out there, proper grand final atmosphere. Is this the kind of game where you bring more than one game plan, or do you know what you're setting out to
do? I think
we'll
just keep doing what we've done all year. We can't change too much, and we knew the weather. It's classic grand final weather. We spoke about this probably a month ago, and every time it rains at training we talk about it's grand final weather, get used to it, and we just got to stick to our game. What's worked as well all year, and the boys have proven, and they're confident playing that way. So again, we'll stick to that same game plan no matter what the weather.
What's the last week been about? Fine tuning, just keeping feet on the ground, just getting ready, calm and collected.
Yeah, most of the week's been about process.
we do feel that these events, the emotional build and take care of itself. So, yeah, we're just concentrated on what we need to do to, one, to nullify OKR's strengths, but mainly to showcase the best of us.
Liam Farrell comes back to the side. How useful is his experience going to be this afternoon?
Yeah, very useful. I think his experience is a big one for us, his leadership, but also his game suits his kind of games. He's super fit. So, I'm delighted we've got him.
Everyone's going to talk about the grand slam, the clean sweep, all four. Has that been mentioned this week, or is it just about tonight?
Passing mentioned this week. A couple of weeks ago when we had the week off, we dug into it a little bit more. But since then, it's been process.
Biggest grand final crowd in years, grand final weather as well. It'll be a bit greasy out there. How important is it that you keep your composure in the early stages?
Yeah, definitely. But as well, if an opportunity presents itself early in the game, you've got to be brave enough to take it. So I think the crowd shouldn't affect the decision making. Embrace the crowd. I think it's brilliant for rugby league. OKR have done a fantastic job in building that club over recent years, and we know our fans will turn out as well. So great celebration of Super League.
Well, Frankie, the two teams came into this in fantastic form, as we've said. They came into it ready. The coaches were confident. What we got was 80 minutes of just brutality.
It was, yeah. And the players really had to put in a shift. The atmosphere when they kicked off was unbelievable. And I thought both teams handled it really well, because there could have been errors, there could have been players that have got in their head a bit, but it wasn't like that. Everyone really did their job, and there were only the odd moment where the gaps appeared or mistakes happened, or these exceptional bits of play from French. But for the whole, the teams played really, really well, and we got such a good game of rugby league. The player that I feel most sorry for is probably Ryan Hall, because he was almost like the godfather of Rovers tonight. I thought he was defending so well. He had a couple of try-saving tackles. He did his job in attack. And when I think of players that did such a good game and didn't get the result, Ryan Hall probably stands out. But then on the other hand, Wigan had those players that did the same job for them. So it was a great 80 minutes of rugby league, and one that I'm sure all the fans here enjoyed. Whether you are a Wigan fan or just a neutral, that's what it's all about, isn't it? Coming here and seeing a good game of rugby league, and we got that.
Just to touch on that atmosphere again, you could have lit a match just in the air before this game kicked off.
Yeah, and I guess because of the fact that we did have these two top teams and we have moments of history to be made on either side, Wigan winning the four trophies or Rovers winning the trophy. So both teams had everything to play for their own reasons. Both teams were trying to make history. All the players on the pitch tonight knew that if they came out on top, their name would be written in history for their club. So there was a lot to play for, and the fans felt it. I spoke to a lot of the Rovers fans outside the front, and they were all talking about the fact that we're here. Like, we're here, and this counts for a lot for our fans to be here, and they wanted to make history. So I got the feeling before the game that everybody really felt they were in a bit of a moment for their club.
Well, a massive moment for the clubs, for the sport, for this season. In 2024, the Wigan Warriors are all conquering. Bevan, congratulations, grand final champions again. How does it feel to be top of the Betfred Super League once more?
This one's just, can't put into words this one. I know one of your first ones really special. This one just had a bit more to it. All four in the calendar year, making history for our club. Crazy stuff.
You're holding the Rob Burrow Trophy for the first time, the first winner of it. I don't know if you're aware of it. I'm sure someone's mentioned your try, spookily similar to the one that he scored in 2011. It must be a real honour to lift that trophy with his name on it.
It is, especially an award in his name. Such a special player. Touched millions of people around the world, especially with what's happened. Means probably a bit extra special to me. Haven't lost my mum to MND a couple of years ago, so it's just a bit of an emotional one for me. I'm really privileged.
Final question, mate. All four trophies in one season. You touched on it. How special is that?
You can't explain it. Like I said, this one probably had that bit more feeling to it, because it hasn't been done before by our club, so We really wanted to make history, you know, for ourselves, for our family, for the community. We'll enjoy this one for the next couple of days.
Matty, congratulations. Betfred Super League champions again. You're making a habit of this.
Good game, proper grand final, don't care. We're outstanding as they have been all year, and they challenged us for every minute of that game, and their fans were great. Good occasion for Super League, and I'm just very proud that the players got over the line. They were very committed to one another defensively, and then Bevan comes up with a piece of magic.
You haven't conceded a try in four games. Is this a title built on defence?
I think all the titles that have existed in Rugby League have been built on defence, so of course it is, and credit must go to Sean O'Loughlin for the way he prepares our defence. Last year's grand final was the same. And I think that what defence is, it stands for your team spirit and your connection to one another. So that's why it's so important.
All four trophies in one season is one hell of an achievement. I know in pre-season November you'd have laid out that that's what you wanted to do, but now you've done it. How does it feel?
No, it wasn't. It wasn't. I spoke about what we were going to win. I spoke about enjoying it, learning, improving.
Some of the individuals in that group have been there and done it. Some of the individuals in that group obviously doing this for the first time. It feels like, you know, this doesn't feel like an ending. This feels like the next step for you guys.
Yeah, it's not an ending. It wouldn't have been if we'd lost either. We're on a journey together. We just want to keep learning and building our connection with the town, our connection between one another, and so much more to achieve on and off the field.
Just finally, a quick word on your fans.
The reason we do it, you know, we want the team to represent the town and represent the community and look after them, and in turn they look after us. So no, I love them to bits, and I only love this team. And thanks also to Betfred for the support, the Super League this year, unbelievable sponsor.
Well, Jeff, enjoy it, mate. Frankie, Bevan French, emotional speaking to him there. That try, if you put it next to Rob Burrows' classic effort in 2011, spooky how similar they are. He's lifted the trophy in Rob's name. The first time ever to do it. It couldn't be more fitting, could it?
No, it couldn't. And it's amazing to have that trophy in Rob's name. The fact that the try was Rob Burrows-esque was brilliant. And I think you need those players to ignite the fans. You need those players that people can get behind. And every time that French had the ball throughout the match, he just puts half a moment of doubt in the defending team's mind. And that makes the difference. That's why the gaps appear for him. He has that incredible acceleration. And there were a couple of times he could have scored. But the first try really what made the difference, wasn't it?
Well, Frankie, final words on a remarkable day.
I'm thrilled that I've been here. A record turnout, or certainly a turnout that's an increase from recent years. So I hope that everybody that turned up tonight enjoyed it as much as I did. I'm sure that they did. Well, especially the Wigan fans will have done, and they've witnessed Rugby League history. So to everyone that's watched it from home on the telly or came here tonight, this is what the sport's all about. And that group of Wigan players are a generation, you know, that we might not see for a long time.
Well, the party will go long into the night in Wigan. The Wigan Warriors are the Betfred Super League champions again, all conquering here at Old Trafford, and that is a wrap on the 2024 Rugby League season.